happening right now, state officials have initiated emergency operations in response to flash flooding and extreme weather in the Upper Peninsula. According to the National Weather Service, up to 7 inches of rain fell in a matter of hours. At least one injury has been reported. A 12-year-old boy was airlifted to a local hospital yesterday after his basement collapsed. The storms that moved across the UP washed out several roads in the Houghton Hancock area. Dozens of sinkholes also formed across the Keweenaw Peninsula, at least 60 in all. Officials in southern and central Houghton County declared a flash flood emergency Sunday. Sewer lines were exposed and roads in several areas are simply impassable.
The road by my parents' house was kind of caved in, and I saw a bunch of pictures on Facebook and live videos that Taco Bell was, the sign was down, and that the whole valley between it was covered in water.
Majority of us can't even get home. Roads are collapsed, bridges are collapsed, roads are covered in water. Whatever roads aren't collapsed, it's depending whether or not how heavy a vehicle you drive.
It is 18 people have been killed in flooding in Ivory Coast's commercial capital, Abidjan. After intense rainfall overnight, the torrential rain started at 11 p.m. on Monday and continued till 6 a.m. in the morning on Tuesday, causing flash floods of up to 2.5 meters deep. The city of 5 million witnessed heavy rains carrying away cars, destroying homes, and leaving hundreds stranded there. The officials have said that around 150 people been rescued and are in shelter. Emergency agencies continue to search for casualties.
And take a look at this incredible video from the Big Island of Hawaii. This fast lava flow from Fissure 8, it is moving right next to the Leilani Estates community and down to the ocean. Officials say it's the only active vent that is still erupting at this point. More than two dozen fissures have oozed or jetted lava over the past 6 weeks or so. That is, you just can't even look at that enough.
Terrifying.
It's just phenomenal. The video, it's just unbelievable.
Oh gosh.
From Columbus to Richmond to Massachusetts, the heat is on. In Chicago, where it hit 93, umbrellas were out. So was the AC for a time at this animal shelter. The brakes, despite an extreme heat warning.
Those mats are probably a little hot.
It's bad. Well, we just like went from like having 50 degree weather to all of a sudden to 90 degree weather.
Today, it's all about the sizzle. 90 degree readings all around the heat zone, but an approaching cold front promises relief overnight. Until then, 80 million Americans doing what they can to beat the heat. In Albany, a walk in the park, not so easy today.
We try to choose the shaded paths for bike rides or walks just to make sure that we get the exercise that we need, but we stay safe at the same time.
Schools closed early in Jersey City, New Jersey.
I'm very happy because it's like so hot, I would not be able to bear being in school for so long.
The heat is all the more unpleasant because it's come with high humidity. Pushing feels like temperatures past 100 in places. And tonight, a double threat. Damaging winds and severe storms moving through New England.
And excessive heat warning here in Chicago will expire tonight. We should see temperatures come down pretty quickly. The news is not so good for St. Louis. They've actually extended their warning for another day. They could hit 105 heat index tomorrow there.
Thank you.
dans le congélateur et s'est soulevé.
Perth is heading for its wettest June in 5 years with another downpour forecast tomorrow. We're being warned the city will copper soaking from a storm front due to hit overnight, and the southwest and Pilbara is on alert for damaging winds. It's been a wet and wild start to winter in Perth. And it's about to get worse.
Heavy showers at times with rainfall and the odd thunderstorm even possible overnight and early tomorrow through to about midday and early afternoon.
A cell of thunderstorms due to hit the metro region overnight. It could dump up to 30 millimetres of rain in 24 hours. So far this month, 80 millimetres has fallen across Perth. We only need another 29 mils this month to make it the wettest June since 2012, when 140 mils fell in the city's gauges. People in our southwest are being warned to brace for damaging winds tonight and tomorrow. The Bureau issuing a severe weather warning for areas from Mandurah to Walpole, including Bunbury, Busselton, Margaret River and Albany. There's also a severe weather warning in place for parts of the Pilbara and Gascoyne, with storms to hit there late tomorrow. But sadly, the rain won't fall where we most need it. Less than 10 mils expected in the wheat belt.
Over the next few months, the outlook at this stage is that things will be a bit drier and a bit warmer than the seasonal average. So it's not looking particularly favourable for rainfall over the greater region.
The wild June weather is also causing havoc in the east. Temperatures have plummeted in Melbourne and Sydney. Intense downpours caused flash flooding, even bursting a dam in Melbourne's. But the freezing temperatures, welcome news for skiers in the alpine regions.
Elsewhere around the world, over in Japan, a magnitude 6.1 tremor shook up Osaka this morning. It's reported 3 lives were lost due to the quake. Cha Sang-mi gets us up to speed with the developments.
It wasn't an ordinary 8 a.m. rush hour for commuters in Japan's second largest city on Monday. A powerful earthquake shook northern Osaka, leaving at least 2 men and a 9-year-old girl dead, and at least 234 others injured. Japan's Meteorological Agency reported that the quake, with an initial magnitude of 5.9, later revised up to 6.1, struck inland at a depth of 10 kilometers. Power outages have been reported as well as light damage to a few train stations, causing some services to be halted. Roads suffered severe damage and water pipes burst, sending water flowing onto streets of Takatsuki City, where the biggest shock was felt. No tsunami warning was issued and no irregularities were spotted at the nuclear plants in the area, according to Kansai Electric Power, but more than 170,000 households had no power temporarily. Japanese Prime Minister Shinzo Abe told reporters that authorities were assessing the damage and that the safety of residents comes first.
The government is working as one to save lives after the earthquake that hit the region around Osaka City.
Seoul's Unification Ministry announced there were no South Korean casualties in Osaka and that they had sent out security concern text messages to those living in or aboard visiting Japan and will continue to assess the situation. Japan's weather agency warned people in western Japan to be prepared for another big earthquake in the next few days.
Antarctica is now melting three times faster than ever before. That's according to a new international study. Scientists say since 1992, 3 trillion tons of ice has melted. Overall, world sea levels have risen about 20 centimeters in the past century. If the right decisions are not made to preserve Antarctica in the next 10 years, the consequences will be felt around the world.
Antarctica has in it enough ice that if it all melted, sea levels will rise globally by over 60 meters. What we're starting to see are the first signs of some of that ice starting to melt. And so it's completely possible for Antarctica to contribute several tens of centimeters in this century.
Coastal flooding during storms at high tides will be more damaging and a threat to cities from New York to Shanghai, as well as low-lying nations from the Pacific Ocean to the Netherlands. Some changes are already irreversible, but by reducing CO2 emissions, this will help towards preventing the situation worsening.
A billboard that's gone up in Northbridge has been labelled dangerous and its message likened to child abuse. The state government wants the anti-vaccination advertisement torn down. Questions are now being asked as to why it was allowed to go up in the first place.
Whooping cough killed baby Riley. He was only 32 days old, too young to be vaccinated.
I'd really hate for another parent to go through a similar experience simply because they've been scared into not vaccinating.
That's exactly what this billboard advertisement at the corner of William and Brisbane Streets aims to do.
They're trying to effectively abuse our children.
Doctors and the health minister say free speech is no defence for the ad from American anti-vax group Learn the Risk, now targeting WA parents. The owner of the shop the billboard's attached to says he is paid to have it there, but he says he didn't realise the advertisement's message. If he had, he would have objected. But getting rid of the ad might not be easy. The City of Vincent says it doesn't have the power to. Roger Cook has asked the health department to check if it can be pulled down under public health laws.
I'm not sure that we have the necessary safeguards in place to ensure that these harmful misinformation campaigns get out there. We should.
Chris Meldrum, 7 News.